In this video, we will do a quick introduction to our Arduino board. In this case, I have the Sparkfun RedBoard in front of me. So when you have this board, you take a look. One of the first things we're going to need to do is power this board. There are two options to powering it. One is through this port right here, this DC barrel connector. You could connect a battery pack or a AC wall adapter to this. It accepts either 9 volts or 12 volts to this. An easier way to connect in most projects, and that's what we'll do for almost all of the projects we will be working on, is to connect power through this USB port right here. So with a USB cable, if we just connect this one end of the USB to your computer and the other end of the USB to the RedBoard, you can power your board for most applications that don't draw as much current. So when you plug that in, a couple of things happen. The power LED that's right here lights up, indicating that the board is now powered and is ready to go. There are a couple more LEDs here. This LED right here is connected to one of the digital ports, pin number 13. So that LED light emitting diode is connected to the digital ports. This side of the Arduino header, this is the Arduino header, and this side of the Arduino header, numbered 0 through 13, are used for digital inputs and outputs. This part of the header is used for analog inputs. There is a total of 6 different analog input channels, 14 different digital input output channels. So 6 input, 14 out, IO input and output digital. Analog is only input. And then here's a separate bus or a connector for power. So here's if you want to kind of power this board from externally without using the barrel connector, you can also do it through VIN. Here's a ground, two ground ports, a 5 volt port, a 3.3 volt port, and so forth. These 5 volts and 3.3 volts are and ground are useful for bringing power to the rest of the circuitry that we might be building on a breadboard on this side, but more on the breadboard in the next video. So far, we powered the board. The green LED indicates that the board is good to go. Now, I'm going to bring up, while I bring up something, focus on these two lights right here, the one that is TX and RX. TX and RX basically stand for transmit and receive. So when I download code into this board, I'm going to do it through this USB cable, and I have my board connected right now, and using the Arduino software, I'm going to hit download. So watch these lights. So you notice that those lights flickered for a bit, TX and RX. So let me do that again. So data was being transmitted and received onto this board. So that is the actual computing system right there. So that's the Atmega processor, Atmega processor that houses the Arduino bootloader. So right here is a push button switch called the reset button. We can press the reset and it'll clear any code and will restart the RedBoard, and it'll restart your code right there. This header right here that says ISP, it's called an in-system programming header. We won't be using it as much in this code, in this particular course. But these two LEDs let you know when code is being downloaded. This LED, as I said, is connected to this port 13. Later on, we'll be talking about digital circuits and digital signals. There's a particular type of digital signal called pulse width modulated signal. All the digital ports that have a small tilde sign right next to it, for example, 3 has it, 5 has it, 6 has it, 9, 10, and 11. So there's a total of 6 different digital ports that are capable of producing a pulse width modulated signal. More on that in a later video. So we have a basic layout of the board. And next video, we'll quickly talk about the breadboard.